हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम पूनम घारगे फ्रॉम कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर बारामती. इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट पॉपुलेशन जेनेटिक्स. सो यू आर ऑलरेडी फैमिलियर विद द वर्ड जेनेटिक्स फ्रॉम योर प्रीवियस कोर्सेस. सो जेनेटिक्स इज नथिंग बट इट इज़ द ब्रांच ऑफ बॉटनी विच डील्स विद द स्टडी ऑफ हेरिडिटी एंड वेरिएशन. सो हेरिडिटी इज नथिंग बट इट इज़ द transmission of one character from its parent to its offspring, and variation means variability which is present among the individual. Okay, so what is mean by population? So you know that an ecosystem consists of many pieces. If you remember, there are so many types of ecosystem we are having, such as a pond ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem, aquatic ecosystem. So each ecosystem consists of many species. So species means what again? So species is nothing but it is a group of living organism comprising of a similar individual. So species means it consists of a group of organism, group of individual, they are having the same genotype. They are capable to do exchange of gene through the interbreeding, or through intermating they can make a exchange of their gene. So such a group is called as a species. So individuals of a same species of a particular region are called as population. So the individual belongs to same species, they are living on a particular location, are called as a population. Or in another term, we can explain population consists of all such individual that share the same gene pool. They belongs to same gene pool, or they have an opportunity to intermate with each other and contribute to the next generation of the population. Got it? So population means what? It is a group of individual which is living on a specific definite place, which belongs to a particular species, and they can interact, interbreed and exchange their genetic material. So population means a group of individual of a particular species which is living on a particular location, in which the individual can able to do a interacting, means they are able to communicate with each other, they can interbreed with each other, and they can make an exchange of their genetic material. They can share their gene pools with each other. So such a group is called as a population. So apart from its ecological significance, this population is population has an important role in the process of evolution. Okay, so population genetics means what? So population genetics is nothing but it is the study of change in the frequencies of allele and genotype within a population. So population genetics means what? Here we are making a study of how much change in that genotype frequency or allele frequency takes place. So that is called as a population genetics, or it is the study of genetic structure of a population and how they change geographically and over time. So population genetics means what? It is the study of genetic structure of a particular population, and with passage of time how much change takes place in that genetic structure that we are studying here. So that branch is called as a population genetics. So before starting with population genetics, we have to study few important concept. So first concept is gene. So what is mean by gene? So gene is a discrete unit of heredity information which consists of specific nucleotide sequence in DNA. So gene means they are the unit of heredity information, and that heredity information is carried in the form of specific nucleotide sequence. The next one is allele. So allele is the alternative form of a gene. So it is an alternative form of gene that is called as a allele. The next one is genotype. So genotype is the genetic makeup of an individual. So if we consider a single individual, so whatever a genetic constitution present in that individual, so that genetic constitution is called as a genotype. The next one is phenotype. So it is the physical trait or a physical appearance of an organism, how this person looks, so that is called as a phenotype. So it is a physical appearance of an organism. The next concept is allele frequency. So allele frequency is nothing but it is the proportion of a specific allele at a given locus. So you know that if we say gene, any gene consists of two alleles, okay, either they are in the dominant form or a recessive form. So dominant allele and recessive allele we are having. So in a population, if we consider the population, how much proportion of that specific allele, specific means either dominant or recessive, at a given locus, considering that the population may contain from one to many alleles at that locus, okay. So allele frequency means what? Frequency of a specific allele at a given locus. So that is called as a allele frequency. The next one is a genotype frequency. So here proportion of that specific genotype which is present at a given locus, that is called as a genotype frequency. So if we consider genotype, either we are having homozygous dominant genotype, heterozygous dominant genotype, or recessive genotype, recessive homozygous genotype. So proportion of that specific genotype present at the given locus is called as a genotype frequency. The next one is a phenotype frequency. So the proportion of individual in a population having the same phenotype. So it is a proportion of an individual. Suppose you are having this plot and you are having here 100 plants, and out of these 100 plants, 10 plants are going to show you the same phenotype or same character. So out of 100, these 10 plants are having the same phenotype. So that is the proportion of that individual which is present in a population that is exhibiting a same phenotype, that is called as a phenotype frequency. So this 10 plant out of 100, so again 10% they are having that specific phenotype. The next concept is Mendelian population. So one by one we are going to see gene pool, gene frequency, genotype frequency, Hardy-Weinberg law, and evolutionary forces in a population. So first one is, what is mean by Mendelian population? That is the another concept. So Mendelian population means what? If you remember, there are two types of populations we are having. That is random mating population, and another one is a Mendelian population means what? It is a group of sexually interbreeding organism, okay? Or these are the individuals of a population have equal opportunity of mating with any other individuals of that population. So such a population is called as a Mendelian population or panmictic population. Okay. So it is also called as a genetic population or random mating population. So definition is, it is a community of a similar individual living within a circumscribed area at a given time and capable of interbreeding to produce fertile offspring. Okay, so Mendelian population means what? It is a group of individual which is living on a specific region at that particular time, and they are capable to do a interbreeding, intercrossing, and at the end, after intercrossing, they will produce a fertile offspring. So that offspring is having the ability to do a intermating. Okay, so such a population is called as a Mendelian population. So how we can recognize Mendelian population? So it is characterized by individuals having somewhat similar genetic constitution. So within Mendelian population, almost all the individuals, they are having a same genetic constitution. So on the basis of that, we can identify Mendelian population. The next one is a gene pool. So gene pool is nothing but, it is the sum total of gene of all the individuals of a Mendelian population, or it is the sum total of gene present in that particular population, that is called as a gene pool. Okay, so gene pool going to represent the population, as well as it will help us to know the proportion of different kinds of gene which is present in that population, as well as through gene pool we can also know the pattern of distribution of genes in individual of population. Okay, so gene pool means sum total, a total number of genes which is present in a population, or all the individuals which is present in a population. So summation of all the genes called as gene pool. So here we have taken one example. Suppose seed set of pea plant. So you know that for this, if you remember Mendel's law, he taken a 7 characters. So for this seed set, we are having 2 alleles, that is smooth allele and wrinkled allele. Okay. So we should also know how these alleles are distributed among the individual. So we are having homozygous and heterozygous individual. Okay. So we are going to consider that one further, the example. But before that, we want to know about the gene frequency or allelic frequency. Okay. So gene frequency is nothing but, it is the proportion of an allele in the gene pool as compared to the other allele at the same locus, with no regards to their distribution in organism. Is that clear? So we are having a 2 alleles for a single gene. So proportion of that single allele in gene pool compared to the other allele at the same locus, that is called as a gene frequency or allelic frequency. So here we are taking one example. Suppose you are having a hypothetical population which is having a 2 allele, that is capital A and small a, dominant allele and recessive allele on a locus. So A is dominant while small a is a recessive one. So we expect 3 types of individual. So 1/4 homozygous dominant, which consists of genotype capital A, capital A. Then 50% of the population will be heterozygous for this gene. So heterozygous dominant, which having a genotype capital A, small a. and 25% means 1/4 population will be homozygous recessive, which consists of genotype small a, small a. So this is an example, okay? So suppose you are having 100 individuals in that population, okay? Suppose you are having 100 individuals in a population in which 40 individuals are having a genotype capital A, capital A. 40 individuals are having a genotype capital A, small a, and 20 individuals are having a genotype small a, small a. It means they are homozygous recessive. Then we are calculating the frequency of these two alleles, capital A and small a, by the formula. We have to consider in total how many alleles we are having. So suppose homozygous dominant, we are having a 40 individual, and in this 40 individuals we are having two alleles in each individual. So 40 into 2, so it will be equal to 80, okay? Then we have to also consider here a heterozygous dominant parent having a one dominant gene and one recessive gene. So here we are having a 40 dominant allele. So if you want to calculate the frequency of this capital A allele, we have to consider the alleles which is present in homozygous dominant parent and heterozygous dominant parent. So frequency of capital A or dominant allele is equal to 80 plus 40 divided by 200. So how we get 200? So we are having a 100 individual and one individual is having a two alleles. So 100 into 2. So therefore we are having here 200. So the frequency of this capital A or dominant allele is 120 divided by 200. So therefore it is 0.6. In the same manner we can calculate the frequency of recessive A allele, that is here from heterozygous dominant parent we are having a 40 this recessive allele, and through population we are having a 20 individual which is having a recessive genotype. So 20 multiplied by 2, so you are having again a 40 alleles. So therefore we are having here 40 plus 40. So 80 divided by 200, so you will get a frequency of recessive allele is equal to 0.4. So thus the gene frequency or allelic frequency can be calculated by dividing the number of particular allele in population with total number of allele present in that population on the locus. So on that specific locus, how many total number of genes are present, we have to consider, as well as we have to consider the number of that particular allele in the population. So by dividing this particular number of particular allele by total allele present in that population, you will get a gene frequency or allelic frequency. Okay, so suppose if we consider the frequency of this dominant allele, that is the A, capital A, that is represented by letter P, and that of gene or allele small a, that is represented by Q, then we will establish here one equilibrium or a gene equilibrium. So the total frequency of both the allele is equal to 1. So therefore we can write P plus Q is equal to 1. So if you know the frequency of one allele, you can able to calculate the frequency of another allele by this equilibrium. Okay, so this is called as a Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. So how to calculate the frequency of P So P is equal to 1 minus the frequency of Q. Or in the same manner, if you want to calculate the frequency of Q, so Q is equal to 1 minus P. So by this equilibrium or by this formula, you are able to calculate the frequency of another allele if you know the frequency of one allele. The next one is genotype frequency. So genotype frequency is nothing but it is the total number of kind of individual from a population, all of which exhibit similar character with respect to the locus under consideration. So here we have to consider genotype frequency means proportion of that particular genotype in a population at that locus is called as a genotype frequency. So as I already told you, we are considering the same example. We are having one locus with two allele, that is capital A and small a. Okay, so in this population we are having a three types of genotype: homozygous dominant genotype, heterozygous dominant genotype and homozygous recessive genotype. Okay, so how to calculate the genotype frequency? So n means total number of individuals in the population. Then we are using here another terminology, that is D. So D means total number of homozygous dominant individuals. H means total number of heterozygous dominant individual, while R means total number of homozygous recessive. Okay, so if you want to calculate the frequency of genotype capital A capital A means homozygous dominant, so formula is genotype frequency is equal to D upon N. So D means total number of homozygous dominant individuals divided by total number of individuals in a population. In the same manner, you can calculate the genotype frequency of homozygous dominant allele, genotype by the formula H upon N. And for recessive dominant individual, you can calculate by dividing R by total number of individuals. So R upon N. Okay. So genotype frequency means it is nothing but it is the frequency for a particular type of gene combination on the same locus and can be determined by dividing number of individual with that genotype by total number of individuals in the population. So if you want to calculate genotype frequency of particular genotype, you have to take total number of individuals from a population having that genotype divided by total number of individuals. The next one is Hardy-Weinberg law. Or it is called as a Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium also. Okay. Hardy-Weinberg law is the fundamental law of population genetics, and that provides the basis for studying Mendelian population. So this law was independently developed by the G.H. Hardy, who is a mathematician, and William Weinberg, who is a physician in Germany. Okay, so according to these two persons, this Hardy-Weinberg law states that the relative frequencies of various kinds of genes and alleles in large and randomly mating, means panmatic population, tend to remain constant from generation to generation in the absence of mutation, selection and gene flow. Okay, so according to these two persons, they said that gene and the genotype frequencies in a Mendelian population remains constant or same from generation after generation if there is no selection, no mutation, migration or random drift. Is that clear? So frequencies, this allelic frequencies or genotype frequencies doesn't change if their selection forces are not acting on the population. So there are certain assumptions are framed. In that conditions only Hardy-Weinberg law will be applicable. Okay. So population at Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium must have to satisfy the five conditions. Okay. So first condition is it requires a very large population size. First assumption is in order to operate this law, population size must be larger. In small population, there are chances of fluctuation in the gene pool, genetic drift, and thereby there will be changes takes place in the genotype frequency with passage of time. Okay. Second assumption is no migration, no movement. Okay, or no transfer of individuals or allele from one location to the another location. So gene flow or the transfer of allele due to movement of individual or gametes into or out. So within a population, in or out of the population can change the proportions of allele. So when this Hardy-Weinberg law operate, when there is a no migration, no movement of individual from the population or from another population cannot be merged in that your target population. Then third condition is no net mutation. Okay. So if one allele can mutate into another, the gene pool will be altered. Okay. So in order to operate this law, there will be no net mutation. Then fourth one is random mating. So if individuals pick mates with certain genotype, then there is a chances of mixing of gamete and that will be not random. So Hardy-Weinberg law cannot be occur if there is a random mating will not takes place. Okay. So random mating is required in order to operate a Hardy-Weinberg law. And the last one is no natural selection. If natural selection takes place, there will be change takes place in the frequencies of allele in the next generation, and therefore your population will deviate from the frequencies which is predicted by the Hardy-Weinberg equation. But generally evaluation takes place which results when any of these five conditions are not met. When a population experiences deviation from the stability predicted by a Weinberg theory. So if this out of this five assumption any condition or any assumption is not met, then only evaluation takes place. Otherwise, if these conditions are always met, we will not experience the evaluation in the population. Okay. So here we can study this Hardy-Weinberg law with one example. So suppose you are having a panmictic population or Mendelian population with a gene capital A, small a. So here we are having a two allele. One is dominant allele, one is recessive allele at a one locus. So the frequency of gamete which is having this allele A and will be same as the frequency of your capital A gene. In the same manner, gametes which is having a recessive allele, they are also having the same frequency of recessive A gene. Okay, so let us here assume you are having a population in which there is a homozygous dominant individuals comprise 36% part of your population. Then homozygous dominant parent consists of 48% part of your population, and this recessive dominant parent comprises 16% part of your population. Okay, so individuals which is having a capital A genotype, they are having a 36% part of the total population, and therefore 36% of all gamete contribute the capital A genotype. In the same manner, this recessive means small a individual will produce 16% of all the gamete which is having this recessive allele. Okay, suppose these gametes from heterozygote individual, they will have capital A as well as recessive A gene in equal proportion. So out of 48% part of your total population, 24% gametes will having a capital A gene, and 24% population or gametes will have a recessive A gene. Okay, so here you can say we are having initially 36% part of your population which is having a capital A genotype. So gametes, here we are also having the 36%, whatever gametes produced by this population, that is 36% gametes will have this capital A gene. Then we are having a heterozygote population which is comprising 48% part of your population. So out of this heterozygote, 24% gametes produce this dominant allele gametes. Okay, so if you sum up this, so this dominant allele will have a 60% frequency in the population. Okay, so 36 plus 24, it will 60%. So in the population you are having 60% capital or a dominant allele, while in the same manner recessive parent population is 16%, so they will produce 16% recessive allele gametes. In the same manner, heterozygote population will produce 24% recessive allele gamete. So if you sum up these two, so 16 plus 24, it means whatever gamete produced by the population, out of that 60% gametes have a recessive alleles. Got it? So if this gamete meets randomly, if this gamete unite at random, so total number of different genotype will be, so suppose you are having here a sperm or gametes, a capital A and recessive A. So suppose this capital A met with capital A, then capital A met with your recessive A, recessive A met with your capital A allele, in the same manner recessive A with recessive A. So suppose you are having mating between capital A and capital A gamete, the frequency is 60%. So 60 into 60, again you are having a 36% population progenies which is having a genotype homozygous dominant. Okay, if this capital A allele met with your recessive allele, then frequency, gene frequency 60 into 40. So that will comprise 24% individuals which is having a heterozygous dominant genotype. In the same manner, recessive A from male parent crossed with capital A from female parent, the frequency will be again 24% heterozygous individual. And again, recessive A from male parent, recessive A from female parent, the frequency will be 40 into 40. So that will going to produce 16% homozygous recessive plants in the population. Okay, so again if you see here, so this allele frequencies again or genotype frequencies is not going to change in this new progeny. They remain same that we have taken as an example. Okay, so again if you produce the gamete from this population, you will get again 60% population of A allele and 40% population of recessive A allele. So frequencies of allele and genotype remain constant if there is no migration, no selection, no mutation takes place. Okay, so suppose the frequency of this capital A allele is represented by letter P and that of recessive allele is represented by letter small q, and if we are assuming there is a random union of gamete takes place, then the frequency of the gene capital A and small a in the generation after generation is equal to, you can see here, this is from male parent and this is from female parent. So frequency, if you want to calculate the frequency of genotype, so a, so p into p means p square. In the same manner here we are having a capital A small a, so p into q. Again here we have p into q, and in this corner we are having a, so q into q means q square. So genotype frequency is equal to capital A plus 2 individuals, you are having 50% individuals with this heterozygous dominant plus recessive dominant genotype. And if you want to calculate the gene frequency, we are using this formula, p square plus 2pq plus q square. So this is used to calculate the gene frequency from this table. Okay, so the results could be explained by relying on the theory of probability. So suppose large size of probability receiving the gene capital A from both parent, then p into p is equal to p square, while probability of receiving this recessive allele from both parent is equal to q into q, so q square, and probability of being heterozygous will be pq plus pq, so is equal to 2pq. Okay, and therefore the relationship between the gene frequency and genotype frequency can be expressed as p square plus 2pq plus q square is equal to 1, or simply in bracket p plus q bracket complete bracket square is equal to 1. So this is the relation, so this relation is known as Hardy-Weinberg formula of binomial expression. So from this equation it is clear that in large random mating population, not only the gene frequencies but also genotype frequencies will remain constant generation after generation. They are not going to change. Okay.